It's cold and it's smooth.
I like a combination of chocolate and vanilla.
It's refreshing in the summer.
Because it makes me fat.
Your cones pleasure me every night.
Americans love ice cream. Last year, we scooped out, spooned in, and licked up over 14 quarts apiece. And New Englanders do it best.
Boston is the ice cream capital of the world. Our per capita consumption exceeds virtually any other part of the United States and is far in excess of what you find in the southern states.
And Brigham's caters to our distinct tastes.
There's a strong preference for coffee ice cream up here, as an example. Coffee, once you go outside New England, fades off very fast.
Since 1914, Brigham's has survived through World Wars, the Great Depression, to today's ice cream wars. The company has established itself as a New England tradition. It's not just because of its ice cream cone with Jimmy's, it's for its employees too. The company proudly estimates that at least one member out of every 10 Massachusetts families has an employee who once worked at Brigham's. Brigham's first store was located in Newton Highlands. The 5 and 10 cent cones, as well as 20 cent sundaes, brimmed over with such generous portions that Newton police had to dispatch additional officers to control the crowds and cars on the weekends. When banks were closed in 1933, Brigham's authorized its managers to accept IOUs from customers who didn't have any cash. At their peak, the IOUs amounted to $25,000. A year later, almost all were paid back. 1962 was a very good year. John Mugar, then president of Star Market, took over at the helm of Brigham's. Soon afterwards, things started to happen. 40 new stores opened, and the restaurant menu was expanded. At its peak, Brigham's had 100 stores. But in the 80s, the company fell on hard times with new competition and management struggles. One by one, the neighborhood ice cream parlors closed down till only 63 were left. But now the company has a new president with a new direction, and once again, Brigham's is turning a profit.
We're probably the only ice cream company that I know last year that had a major growth in sales in packaged ice cream. Our sales went up 18%.
Brigham's has gone through some tough times with sales dropping and the number of restaurants dropping from 100 to 63. What now for the company?
Was a time when a dipping shop was all you needed to make money in the ice cream. But today you need more than dipping. You need something that levels out your sales year round. You need to offer food. You need to have customers who want food.
Very little has changed in the actual recipe or production of Brigham's ice cream, except for a few new additions. Each day, 9,000 gallons of ice cream roll off these assembly lines. Claudia Cost is the director of manufacturing. She also has the delectable job of creating new flavors.
Actually, I've been working on a new frozen yogurt flavor called creamery nut. And we're just looking for something that around the holidays, around Christmas and Thanksgiving, that people might like. Along the yogurt line. Basically, I just sit here and I add a little bit of concentrate until I get to the flavor that I'm looking for, and then I might freeze it up. I have a small freezer and I freeze it up, and then I add the nuts and the cranberries, and then I take it to a flavor panel and everybody tastes it and makes suggestions, and then I go back and I probably make 10 to 15 batches.
Brigham's jumped onto the bandwagon early. Frozen yogurt provides a tasty alternative to ice cream lovers who don't want the cholesterol.
I'm not old enough to worry about cholesterol yet. I hope not, anyways.
I don't think ice cream causes cholesterol, does it?
Oh yes, there is cholesterol in ice cream, but frozen yogurt is 96% fat-free and is gaining popularity at Jack Kopelnik's store in Belmont.
I think the yogurts will bring it back, and also the weather. If the weather turns over and the yogurts and people more and more into yogurts.
Jack has owned this store for almost 3 decades, and it's a family affair. His son and camera-shy daughter work behind the counter.
I've been here a long time, and we've devoted our time and service to the person coming into the store. So we have regulars. We know regulars by names. My children know the regulars by names. And we know when they walk in the store what they want.
Customer loyalty may be sweet, but Brigham's knows the recipe for success has got to change with the times.
Tradition to us is only one part of our mix. Forward movement, new things, new developments, constant change is the other part of our mix.